Postnuptial agreement. Ever wondered how assets are shared between couples in the event of a divorce or separation, where parties have signed postnuptial agreements? After being married for 5 years, Ada is making very good money from her several tech deals. She decides for the safety of her children that a postnuptial agreement be entered into with her spouse. It's worthy to note that Ada is worth much more than her husband. However, her husband took an offense and stated she was already foreseeing an end to the marriage because she had started earning more money than him. Their parents condemned Ada for suggesting such an agreement, and this has caused a major rift between the couple. Ada is still adamant on the postnuptial agreement. A postnuptial agreement, also referred to as a postmarital agreement, is a legal document designed for couples who are married or in a civil union. Although similar to a prenuptial agreement, postnuptial agreements are entered into after the marriage has commenced. It establishes how the couple's assets will be divided in the event of a divorce or legal separation, and the amount, if any, for spousal support that one spouse will pay to the other if the marriage ends. What should Ada do?
There's something you are hiding. First of all, we have married the marriage already. We are in it, 5 years inside it. You are now successful in your business. That success, was the man not there? Behind every successful woman is a man.
No, I agree.
Want to safeguard your children, your fear is that your children, very, very simple now. Shiba, I was just talking about investments. The investments I was liquidating were not in my name now. As much as I give birth to a child, I have three. I can't shout. Omo, straight up. Three investments in your name, your account is set up, your life assurance policy in your name is set up, and you're my next of kin. But for you to now come and tell your husband to come and sign paper now, ah, babe, why now? Yeah. If it was the man that does it, will we do this? No, now. Equity.
No, sorry. I think that while that might be the natural sometimes assumption, and maybe why the parents are talking, I think that at this point in time, before we look at blanket situations, the questions that I would personally look at and I would take in this situation would be to actually leave the veil. And I can sense that this conversation is coming from a legal standpoint. I will leave the veil and say to myself, what are the red flags or signals or signs or reasons behind the decision to have this agreement? So there might, let's ask ourselves, it's not, and I do not subscribe to behind every successful man or woman is the other person. The first person that is behind you is yourself and then the universe and your partner, whatever it is. So what I'm going to say here, right here, is this, that there is a reason to check what are the spending or financial habits of the other partner. And whether it was a man that came up with it or a woman that came up with it, any party is allowed. There's a freedom of decision. With the fact that we're joined together doesn't mean that I should not be able to make decisions. And we are moving from a society where, I mean, I don't know how to put it without going out of place. Bottom line of what I'm trying to say here is that... What I'm trying to say here is that Ada cannot be entirely said to be unclean for wanting to do that. But what I would then say is that in a situation where there's really no discord or there are no other things, maybe there's a possibility that she needs to look and say, okay, what kind of planning or agreement or plans can we make? Because in the definition given of a postnuptial agreement, it's in the event of a separation or a divorce. And so that finality around it kind of puts a problem.
True.
But if there's another type of planning that can be done, this is where I would now want to agree with HMI in terms of, okay, what kind of investments or decisions or budgeting or planning can be done. But even at that, you still need to have the conversation with the other party, and the person may not even... Not every woman is an A-type person and able to just make those decisions as to what to do with their money or how to invest it. And so if, for any reason, hands are tied or something, please, Ada, go on. Have that agreement done.
My question and my concern is, how legal is this? Is this allowed by law?
Very legal, yes.
Very legal. That's after the wedding.
It's consented by two parties.
Yes, that's
if the husband agreed, if the husband agrees and they both decide to go ahead, then it is very legal. Mm-hmm. It's just like a prenuptial agreement. You have a postnuptial agreement. If she believes or if she sees reasons that make her decide that, okay, just in case something happens, I want to be sure that
what if the
this guy is going to leave with my money, or vice versa. I don't think there's anything wrong with that.
What happens when the husband says
what
no?
Happens when the husband, like the question that she, what happens
if, oh yeah, so that's the point where she's at. The
okay, so Ada, said, what will now become the solution? Ada, sorry, not you. Titi, oh yeah, pick your tent. Let's know where you are.
He says no. If I'm the one, no, I will say no.
True.
After we are married, then you now wake up and decide that, oh, now I want a postnuptial
agreement. No, that's not your money, so why are you?
I'm part of your life.
Yes.
I'm part of your work. The fact that you can go and make this money is not... You can't now exclude me from this. No.
No, I think...
No, you don't make your success behind
but you know
me.
What, but you know what? I think also there's a lot of entitlement that comes up in marriages, both on
if
the
you're
side
married to
of
me, I'm so
men
entitled
and
to
women.
You.
No, I'm not saying we're not entitled, and that's the honest truth. But I think that there's a lot of entitlement that sometimes comes in. What I think is should go on here is proper communication around these things. Okay, so you know there needs to be the place of open, honest, hardcore conversations around why are we doing this? What is going on? And the fact people say, especially women, like this is just another. If you, I was there when you made your money. First, I'm not disagreeing, but if you were there when I was making my money, I need to ask and itemize what sacrifices particularly did you make in my life.
I will have plenty.
Let me run
that. I will have plenty.
I will have plenty. My dear.
Question
is, even in ordinary marriages, what is not
as far as I'm concerned, giving off of her money. If he does not plan on living off of her money, there's nothing wrong in her saying, you know what, to secure in case this thing doesn't work out at the end, I want to know that my money is my money.
That's what I'm worried about.
Way, it doesn't sound to me as if something is going on correctly in that relationship. You get midway, then you suddenly now jump the bus and say, wait, apart from that, she's now coming into the money. She's coming into the money. And so she's become a different person. That's why there's this viral meme that says, oh, please check your humility before you become a rich. By the time you are rich, we'll now know who you are in person. Ada don't show the real color now. Now that Ada is rich, she wants to secure the bag. But before she broke even, she was carrying Mr. Husband along. See, let's be fair. When it comes to equity, it must come with clean hands. If Titi was a man and she came on to the show today with this point of view, you can be rest assured that we will shred him.
No, I disagree. I wouldn't.
We will
I would
shred
stand
that right
here.
Your wife was there. No. She carried your baby. She sacrificed her life. Yeah. Made sacrifices.
I wouldn't shred
the place.
If this was a man.
Now, you're not telling me 5 years into the marriage, you need a prenup? Guy, check
something,
yourself.
There must be a reason for something. And I'm serious. No, see, I'm not saying that.
So
you see,
if there's a reason,
that's
why are you still here?
Because you see, no,
if
she doesn't want
reason,
to know.
Why you
no,
still
she's only
she
securing
because of love.
No, she doesn't
property.
Want to do a divorce here. But say, if in case of a divorce or a separation,
she's not coming with clean hands. She's not coming with clean hands. If it comes to equity, must come with clean hands.
No, but do you understand that the agreement is whatever we decide? So
that
it's not
it.
Set in stone. If
thank
we
you.
Say okay,
but the man has said he's not agreeing to the agreement.
I currently am worth 1 million naira, and in the event of a dissolution of the marriage, I'm going to be willing to give you 30% or 40% of what I'm worth. Do you understand? It doesn't mean I'm not. The agreement is not saying, oh, everything goes to me. We're going to sit down and table it and agree that this is the percentage I'm willing to give you a spousal support or whatever it is. I mean, it's an agreement.
Cynthia, I like this table you broke. I thought you broke them, but this one you broke, you've destroyed it. Interesting one.
Anyways, Anytime is next after the break.